Buckingham Palace has found itself in an unexpected spotlight following an awkward typo in a major announcement about Princess Beatrice. The royal family's social media team made a small but glaring mistake, sparking reactions from eagle-eyed royal watchers. The palace took to social media to share two lovely new photographs of Princess Beatrice, who is 36 years old, to announce the exciting news that she and her husband, Eduardo Mapelli Mozzi, are expecting their second child. The new baby is due early next year, bringing joy not only to their family, but to royal fans across the world. However, in what can only be described as an unfortunate blunder, the official announcement featured a notable spelling error. The post read, "Her Royal Highness, Princess Beatrice and Mr. Eduardo Mapelli Mozzi are very pleased to announce that they are expecting their second child together early in the new year, a sibling for Wolfie and Sienna." It wasn't long though before keen-eyed followers of the royal family noticed the typo in the phrase "Her Royal Highness," instead of the correct spelling "Her Royal Highness." The seemingly minor mistake caused quite a stir online, with some fans quick to point out the oversight. One royal enthusiast was among the first to correct the error, replying, "Her Royal Highness," emphasising the correct spelling. Another fan couldn't resist a gentle tease, adding, "Did they not read what they wrote before they post?" The palace's social media team quickly rectified the situation by deleting the post and re-uploading it with correct spelling. While the typo was fixed, the incident certainly provided a bit of unexpected humour to an otherwise joyous announcement. Despite the minor blip, the focus quickly returned to the happy news itself. Princess Beatrice and Eduardo's growing family is a point of excitement for royal watchers. The new baby will be a sibling to the couple's first child, Sienna Elizabeth Mapelli Mozzi, who is 3 years old. Beatrice is also a proud stepmother to Christopher Wolfe, affectionately known as Wolfie, who is 8. Wolfie is Eduardo's son from his previous relationship with an American architect. As with any royal birth, the addition of a new baby has repercussions for the line of succession. This new little one will be 11th in line to the throne, following their mother, Princess Beatrice, and older sister, Sienna. The birth will also nudge Princess Beatrice's younger sister, Princess Eugenie, down to 12th in line for the throne. The royal baby will hold the prestigious position of being a great-niece or great-nephew to King Charles III. Additionally, they will be second cousins to Prince George, Princess Charlotte, and Prince Louis, children of the Prince and Princess of Wales. The next generation of royals is expanding, and this new addition further strengthens the family's ties to the throne. On the paternal side, the baby will be Prince Andrew's 4th grandchild, Princess Eugenie. Beatrice's younger sister has 2 children of her own, August Brooksbank, who is 3, and Ernest Brooksbank, who is just 1. The growing York family is certainly something to celebrate as more and more little ones join the extended royal family. However, like her sister Sienna, this new baby will not receive the title of His or Her Royal Highness. This decision is in line with the established protocols for royal titles, which restrict the HRH status to specific members of the royal family. Even without this title though, the child will still be part of the royal lineage and have a special place within the family, holding the courtesy title of Miss or Master, depending on their gender. In recent years, Princess Beatrice has lived somewhat out of the spotlight compared to more senior royals. Yet, her growing family and the quiet grace which she navigates her royal duties and personal life have endeared her to many. Her upcoming arrival is a point of happiness not only for the York family, but for royal fans across the globe. The positive news of a new royal baby will be welcomed after a difficult 12 months of the royal family, with both King Charles and Catherine undergoing cancer treatment. GBNews' Royal Podcast discussed the return of Catherine.
Yes, the Princess of Wales, her first official work meeting has been recorded in the court circular since she started cancer treatment back in February. Of course, she's had meetings, well, we know, since before Trooping. So Trooping the Colour happened in June, and we know that she had started working from home before that, having meetings with her communication secretaries or private secretaries, but those kind of meetings not recorded in the court circular. This one has been, and that's because it's an official work meeting. So presumably she had, yes, her official household team with her, but also perhaps some external staff from the Royal Foundation Centre for Early Childhood, because the meeting was at Windsor Castle, 5 minute drive or so from Adelaide Cottage, her home in Windsor, on the early years. So it looks like a very small positive step for her.
Yeah, this is promising, and the fact it's come so soon after the video announcement confirming that she's finished her chemotherapy treatment, and within that message, she outlined the fact that she is hoping to do a few public engagements before the end of 2024. So I think this is the step in the right direction, and yeah, I think this is building up now to an actual public return. We've heard that Remembrance Sunday in November has been possibly earmarked as a return. It may come before that. If not, the carol service in December is also a potential return date. But I think that this is a sign now that Kate's readying up to make a return to public duties.
Yeah, and I would suggest that that would be her wish, that she could perhaps carry out a public early childhood engagement, for example, before the end of the year. But Kensington Palace will be very careful to make sure that she isn't running before she can walk. And there is a big difference between travelling 5 minutes up the road to Windsor Castle for a private meeting away from cameras and the public, to having to travel potentially hundreds of miles to the other end of the country to attend a public engagement to do with early years. And we are getting the sense, really, still, that she has good days and bad days with her health. But of course, she has completed her course of preventative chemotherapy. And Prince William alluded to that only a couple of weeks ago, telling some well-wishers in South Wales that it's good news that the princess has clearly finished chemotherapy, but there is still a long way to go, suggesting she has good days and bad days. And what Kensington Palace doesn't want to do is confirm that the princess is going to be doing X engagement, for example, then she has to pull out last minute because she's having a bad day, and then the inevitable hysteria that would be, exploded on online, that the princess has had to pull out last minute is just not worth it. So if there is going to be an engagement, I suspect it's going to be announced very, very close to the time indeed.
Yeah, and we have seen that with the two public appearances Catherine has made this year. The return at Trooping the Colour, I believe, was announced on the Thursday evening, and then she made the appearance on Saturday. And with Wimbledon, it was confirmed on the Saturday morning, and then she made the appearance on the Sunday afternoon. So, yeah, it's about 24 hours, 48 hours notice, and that's probably what's going to continue.
Helen Lashard, also speaking to GB News, reacted to the expected return of the Princess of Wales.
Well, it's been reported today that Princess Catherine is planning for her long-awaited return to public duties. Now, earlier this month, the Princess of Wales, she gave us all an update on her cancer treatment. She told us her course of chemotherapy had been completed. And now, according to new reports, she's holding meetings to plan the annual Westminster Abbey Carol concert. Well, joining us now is Royal Broadcaster Helena Chard. Helena, thank you very much indeed. This is very promising news.
Afternoon. Oh, it's fantastic. We're thrilled to hear this. I mean, obviously, we understood that she was going to begin a light schedule of engagements, and this certainly is happening. And to hear that she's actually going to work on one of the highlights of the royal calendar, it is wonderful. It's certainly a sort of slow and measured return. And obviously, we heard she had a meeting in Windsor, but that was a sort of round table meeting to do with her early years last week. So to hear that she had another meeting is absolutely fabulous. Shows her determination, and sort of we're really willing her on as well. I mean, she wants to get completely well and, get back and work. That's her sort of ambition. And thinking that she spent all that time as well just planning, we're all excited about this concert, and it's the annual Together concert, I think that's what it's called. And just to remember, it's Westminster Abbey, and it's a really huge deal. She's hosted and worked on this for 4 years, and to remember, it's for sort of local charities. And we have celebrities there each year. So it's absolutely
It's been a staple,
fabulous.
Hasn't it? It's become a staple to see Princess Catherine at this carol concert. It's very much a part of the festive calendar for, I'm sure, millions of people in this country and possibly around the world too. We're also looking out for her to be at the Remembrance commemorations too in November. I'm not sure if we've had that confirmed, but it's certainly speculated that she may well be there as well.
She will be. So November the 10th, yes, Remembrance Sunday, I'm pretty sure. She'll be there supporting the royal family, veterans and their families. And then the following, obviously, month, it is the special concert. You know, I think she's really wanting to return to normality. What is normality for her? I mean, she has to take things day by day. But I do feel there'll be lots of little engagements that she will try and fit in if she feels well. I'm just trying to think. We've had Tribune of the Colour, Wimbledon, obviously the Cenotaph, the concert. But she continues to work on her early years projects as well. And I just, you know, just to remember that she will, it's not going to be, I guess, as normal as she previous. I think she will be working as hard as possible, but not to forget she's there. She's supporting the future King of England. She has a young family to look after, and she wants to make the most of that at this time. When she's queen in due course, there'll be many years of absolutely full-on work. But we're so excited to hear that she's working away at the concert. Can't wait to see it and see who's going to be there. It's always a fun time.
Starting to feel strangely festive already, and it's not even the end of September. I think the change in the weather has made it
autumn.
Look forward to the Christmas. That will be certainly a highlight of the festive period. It always is quite magical.
The latest addition to the royal family will continue to draw interest as more details unfold, and the palace will surely be more vigilant with their announcements in the future. Daniel Smith, GB News.